I'm like, hello? I'm like, this fool got this action shit. You told me 10. Hey, what's up? You tired? I heard you was tired, bro.
The first three months ago was good, but fourth and fifth, I got tired.
I'm just wearing it.
I'll check. So, Flacco, tell us what's going on with you, man. I know you just walked in right now.
Yeah, just walked in, about to get some good training in with Coach Berlin. Getting ready for the Eastern qualifiers on Saturday, flying out to Tennessee.
And you're creating a lot of buzz right here in San Diego, man. So, tell us about that.
Just doing me, man. I just started finding my comfort zone and started doing me, you know. Before, I used to never listen in the ring, and I'm just starting to listen and training hard, and it's all starting to come out now.
Tell us about your team here. You know, you have a great team here. It's supportive.
My team is great, man. This is why we're putting our name out for our gym. Our team, all of us just work hard, and, you know, we all push each other to the limits. So we're all going to put our names out there for the bomb squad.
So what wakes you up in the morning as far as boxing? What gets you up? I know you got up a little late today, but...
I got up a little late today, that's right. But what gets me up is just... My mind is just focused on the Eastern qualifiers right now. So what gets me up is coach calls me, tells me to come to the gym early in the morning. So I'm going to be here and I'm going to stay ready for the Eastern qualifiers.
Okay, you fought recently. How did that go?
I fought recently in Nevada. I fought Amado Vargas. He's a good fighter, yeah, but I was just on my A game. I trained hard. I was ready for that fight. And I just boxed him and I did really good.
And, you know, he has a rich history in boxing. His family, you know, Fernando Vargas. How did it feel? Did it bother you? Or did you just say, you know what, this is another?
No, not at all. I mean, when I went in the ring, I heard his crowd, but that just made me more hungry to get the fight, you know? I mean, it was just another opponent for me. And I feel like he completely dominated and just did me.
And it looks like you like to step up under pressure, so that's kind of the type of fighter you are.
Yeah.
And that just brings you to the top peak.
I feel like the underdog there, and that's what I love. That's what makes me feel like a real boxer.
Then tell people a little bit about you that they don't know. Outside of boxing,
a lot of people. I go to college and I'm a student athlete. That's what I do. I also go to college. You know, I don't just box and skip school. You know, I go to college almost every morning, Tuesdays and Fridays. I go to college at 8 to 10, and I do homework right after boxing. Basically, that's all I do. Homework, work, and college. I work at my dad's mechanic shop. I work about 6 hours a day on average. But when I'm close to a tournament, my dad tells me just take some time off just to get ready for the fight.
What do you like about boxing?
It's completely different than every other sport. I mean, there's no team, so you just rely on yourself in boxing.
Right. Tell people where to follow you on social media.
Follow me on Instagram, Johnny_Mansour. JONNY_MANSOUR.
And one last question. How does it feel to wake up every morning and say, man, I'm Johnny Mansour?
Right now, I'm just on the works right now, man. I can't be getting my head too big right now. So every morning I wake up, I just come to the gym and train hard. I don't say I'm Johnny Mansour. I'm just another kid who's training hard, going for that gold medal in the Olympics.
There you go. Thank you.